Hi everyone, welcome to our new video on 5G NR modulation and coding schemes. In this video, we will discuss about the modulation coding scheme or say MCS used in 5G. Let's start with the basic definition and some characteristics of modulation and coding scheme. So modulation and coding scheme basically defines the number of useful bits which can be carried by a symbol. In contrast with 5G or 4G, a symbol can be defined as a resource element or RE. And MCS defined as a how many bits can be transmitted per resource element. In any wireless link, MCS depends on the radio quality. Better the radio quality, higher the MCS. And this higher MCS means we have more useful bits which can be transmitted in a symbol, and bad signal quality result in a lower MCS, which means we can transmit less useful data within a single symbol. So MCS also depend on block error rate or say blur other than the signal quality. Typically, there is a threshold for blur for every MCS, and this is usually 10%. To maintain this blur, the base station or say GNB in 5G keep on changing this MCS based on the radio conditions. And this MCS is communicated to the UE using DCI, which is downlink control information, over PDSS channel. In 5G we have like a DCI 1011, which is used for MCS signaling. MCS basically defines two properties. The first property is modulation and second property is code rate. So let's discuss about modulation and code rate in next slide. Modulation. Modulation defines how many bits can be carried by a single resource element irrespective of whether it is a useful bit or parity bits. 5G NR support QPSK, 16 QAM, 64 QAM and 256 QAM for data channel or say PDSS channel. With QPSK, there are 2 bits can be transmitted per resource element. With 16 QAM, it can be 4 bits. With 64 QAM, it can be 6 bits, and with 256 QAM, it can go up to 8 bits per resource element. This 16, 64 and 256 are known as modulation order of QAM modulation. The number of bits for each modulation order can be calculated using the Schön formula. The 2 raised to power n equal to modulation order. So for 2 raised to power 4 equal to 16. So this n represents here the number of bits. So 2 raised to power 6 equal to 64. Means 64 QAM, 6 bits. 2 raised to power 8 equal to 256. And 2 raised to power 10 is 1024. So if we say QAM order is 1024, it means one resource element can carry 10 bits. The second property of modulation encoding scheme is code rate, or we can also say coding rate. So code rate can be defined as the ratio between useful bit and total transmitted bit. And this total transmitted bit is useful plus redundant bit. These redundant bits are added at the file layer for the forward error correction. In another words, we can say that the code rate is the ratio between the number of bits at the top of physical layer and the number of bits which are actually transmitted or mapped to the PDSS channel at the bottom of the physical layer. So on the right side, we can see this diagram. So here we can see we have n number of bits at top of the physical layer, and after adding this redundant bit, this becomes n plus k, and then these bits, n plus k bits, are mapped on the PDSS channel. So code rate here will be n divided by n plus k, this one. The code rate is a measure of redundancy which is added by physical layer. A low code rate result into high redundancy. Here we can also see a calculation for the code rate using a table from 3GBP. So this table is basically MCS table from physical layer spec. So we can take very first this particular row, where we can see 120, and this 120 is actual bits, whereas the total bits transmitted for this modulation is 1024, this much, and the code rate for this comes as 0.117. MCS tables. In 4G, we were having only single table for MCS for PDSS channel. But in 5G, we have these three tables for different applications. And I have taken this MCS table from physical layer spec 38.214. So we can see at the bottom of each table we have given some name. So very first table is 64 QAM table, and this is similar to your LTE table. Then second table is 256 QAM table, And as per to this table, the maximum MCS can go up to 256 QAM with certain code rate. And the third table is for low spectral efficiency table. So this third table is specifically used for applications which require reliable data transmission and low latency communication. So as per 3GPP use case, this table is very suitable for ultra reliable low latency communication. So in each and every table, we can see the MCS starts from 0 and it go up to 31. So total number of MCS indexes are 32. We can also see here that some of the modulation are shown as reserved, like this 29, 30 and 31 in first table and the third table. So these modulations are reserved for the retransmission, whereas other modulation indexes can be used for normal data. In next slide, we will discuss in what condition the E0B or UE will choose which modulation table. The MCS table selection in 5G can be controlled by E0B using RRC signaling and physical layer signaling. As part of RRC signaling, the E0B sends specific configuration for this MCS table, and the physical layer can control this using MCS CRNTI. Let's take first 256 QAM table example. So we have two cases for this MCS selection related to 256 QAM table. The first case is the dynamic scheduling, and the second case is semi-persistent scheduling. In dynamic scheduling, A0B sends PDSH config as part of RRC signaling, and under this PDSH config, it indicates MCS table which is QAM 256 for 256 QAM table selection. And here the UE will be scheduled with DCI 1_1 with CRNTI. For second case, in SPS scheduling, when the RRC set SPS config without any MCS table and PDSH config with MCS table as QAM 256. Here, the UE is scheduled using DCI 1_1 and CSRNTI, or UE can be scheduled without DCI using SPS config. The second table we can take is low SC table. This low SC table also QAM 64 low SC table. And selection of this table can be done using RRC signaling or physical layer signaling. For physical AS signaling, UE has to be configured with MCS RNTI as well as the CRNTI. And the scheduling for this UE is done with the MCS CRNTI. Here also, we can have two cases like dynamic scheduling and the SPS scheduling. In dynamic scheduling, when the UE is not configured with MCS CRNTI, then A node B send RRC signaling including PDSCH config indicating MCS table, and this MCS table has to be QM64 low SE for this table selection. And in this case, UE has to be scheduled with CRNTI, as there is no MCS CRNTI allocated. SPS config is used for semi-persistent scheduling, and this SPS config shall include MCS table indicating the table choice. And in this case, the UE is scheduled with CSRNTI when using DCI, and when we are not using DCI, it can be scheduled with SPS config. And if we are not able to match the first case and the second case, the by default that it can use the third table, which is 64 QM table. Let's now discuss about MCS table selection with an example. So in this example, we will see how physical layer signaling can control this MCS table selection once initial RRC signaling has been done. So let's consider a UE which is configured with parameter PDSCH config with MCS table as QM256, and it has been allocated MCS CRNTI along with traditional CRNTI. If the UE receives a PDSCH resource using DCI 1_1 with CRNTI, then UE will select 256 QAM MCS table. If the same UE receive PDSCH resource using DCI 1_0 with CRNTI, then this UE will select 64 QAM. So we can see here, just by changing the DCI format from 1_1 to 1_0, the MCS table is changed from 256 QAM to 64 QAM table. If the same UE receive a PDSCH resource allocation using either DCI 1_1 or 1_0, but with this MCS CRNTI, so in this case, the UE will select low spectral efficiency table. So here, the table selection does not depend on DCI, but it depends on MCS CRNTI. And this MCS CRNTI indicate UE to select low spectral efficiency MCS table. So here we end this topic. So thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please like it, share it, and don't forget to follow our channel for next videos. Thank you very much. Have a good day.